In this video, I'm going to show how to make any font into a writing style font for use in Cricut Design Space and with the writing feature of the Cricut Explore models. To do this, you will need to use a vector editing program. I'm using Inkscape. To start, use the text adding feature to type the text that you want to have written, and then choose your font. I'm going to be using Sunlight. When you have an actual project in mind, you should size it correctly for whichever project you're using, but since I'm just practicing today, I'm just going to make it a bit bigger so it's easier to see. The first thing that you need to do then is click on the Path menu and click on Object to Path, which is the shortcut Shift-Control-C. Then you click on the View menu, go down to the Display Mode menu, and click on Outline. This shows us the actual vectors that are involved in the program. This illustrates why the Cricut software will write bubble letters with system fonts, which everyone hates. So that fonts can be sized correctly at many different sizes, they are vectors. Word processing programs like Microsoft Word read the outline at whatever size it is and fill it in with the appropriate text color. This outline is what Cricut Design Space and other word processing systems read, and that is the path that the Cricut will follow. This is why Cricut Design Space just can't write any font as a writing style font, because this is the only information that Design Space has about the font. Cricut has created a few writing style fonts for use in Design Space, which are single stroke fonts that write more similar to how a person holding a pen would write. These fonts, since they do not bound an area, cannot be read by most word processing programs. You would just see nothing there. There would be no information about where to fill in the color. So that's why you really can't find writing style fonts available for download. We're going to use this font as a guideline to create our own writing strokes and pen strokes. Since this font has thin areas and thick areas, I'm going to use one single pen stroke through the thin areas and then a second pen stroke through the thick areas. The tool we're going to be using is the Bezier Curves tool, located over here on the left side of the screen. Clicking in the center of the outline of the letters so that we follow what a pen stroke would follow, I'm just going to start by clicking in straight lines and following the curve around. When using the Bezier Curves tool, you can click and drag in order to create a curve as you're going along. But we don't need to do that because I'm going to show you a really cool, easy trick to use in order to get perfect curves every time. So I'm just using straight curves. And then instead of going down the center of this part, since I am going to use two strokes in this thick part, I'm just going to go down the side a bit. When you reach the end of your letter, press the Enter key on the keyboard to turn it into a curve. And now I'm going to draw the second stroke. I'm going to start at about the same height as the first one starts. Follow it down and come in, have it connect at the bottom here. Now, using my normal selector tool, I'm going to select both the strokes that I just drew, go to the Path menu, and go down to where it says Combine, which is the shortcut Control-K. I'm going to click on Combine, and that just puts both of these paths on the same editable layer. Now you can either double-click on the paths or click on the Edit Path by Nodes button on the left side so that we can see all of the nodes that we just drew. I'm going to turn these nodes into auto-smooth nodes, which will make the letter really nice and curved. So I'm going to start selecting these nodes by just clicking and dragging around them. And then I'm going to click this button up at the top, which is Make Selected Nodes Auto Smooth. And they turn from squares to round. I'm actually going to leave this node up here as a corner because I want the pen to make a sharp movement there. The end nodes will never turn into Auto Smooth nodes, but that's okay, they don't need to be. So you can still select them, they just automatically won't change. Now I'm just going to zoom in a bit. And the great thing about auto smooth nodes is that as you move each node, all the other nodes around it adjust so that there's always a perfectly smooth line, which makes it really easy for following these fonts because you don't have to be perfect. At the bottom, you are going to make sure that both of the paths connect. This will make sure no matter what size pen you're using in the end, that your paths are going to touch and it's going to look seamless. Depending on the pen size you intend to use is how close together these two strokes in the thicker part needs to be. If you're using a very thin pen, you might need to put them closer together or even add a third stroke. But if you're using a thicker marker, then they can be further apart and it will still look seamless in the end. You want to be sure when you are writing your letters that you don't use too few node points. If you do, once you change the curve to have auto smooth nodes, your letter is not going to look much anything like the original font. You can see it's just really curvy here. So if you do that, that's okay. You can either add more nodes by double clicking in the middle of the path and to add more, or you can just Control Z and start over. At the same time, you don't want to have too many nodes. The Cricut machine can only handle so many nodes at one time, and if you have something with a lot of text that has many, many different points of nodes, eventually the Cricut machine will kind of give up and just stop writing your text, which can be very annoying when you have a very long project almost finished and then it stops writing on like the last sentence. So in straight parts, use less because the pen's just going to follow a straight path. But around curves, do add a few more nodes to have the curve be more specific. As you're getting into the more cursive areas or with cursive style fonts, you want to make sure that from one letter to another, the letters connect. So just drag, after you finish two letters, drag the last node of the first letter over and have it touch the second letter. When you get to parts like the dot of the I or other punctuation, you can kind of cheat and use the inherent circle function that Inkscape has. I'm holding Control and Shift while I draw a circle, and that makes it draw out from the center in a symmetrical circle. And you can draw one circle or even two to make sure that the whole dot is going to get filled in. And then make sure that you select both of those circles and also the rest of the eye, and I'm going to hit Control K to combine those together. And then never forget to go back and make the last letter you did touch the next letter you just did. The great thing about writing a lot of text this way is that as you go, you start to work faster and faster because you can go back and use the same path you've already drawn for one letter for another letter. So I'm going to select this G that I have drawn before and press Control D, which stands for duplicate. Now I can drag that over and just place it back in this new G. You'll see as I go through, a lot of letters start to repeat. So in the beginning, you're drawing most of the letters, but as you progress, you can copy over a lot of the letters. All you need to do when you add a new letter in is just make sure that it connects to the other letters around it. You'll notice with a lot of letters, I start at the end of the letter and work my way back. And I just think that's the easiest way for me to look at a letter and make sure I have the least amount of strokes possible. The more individual strokes you draw, the more times the pen is going to pick up and be put back down, so the longer the writing is going to take. So I try my best to have one continuous stroke going through all of the thin parts of the letter, and then to build up the rest of the letter with single strokes and have the least amount used as possible. Sometimes you might realize that you want to change a node back to having it be sharp. So you can do that by clicking on the corner node button twice while you have that node selected. And now, sometimes as you're going along, you will start to realize that there are some places where your single pen stroke could extend longer. So I think that these two letters, W and R, are a great candidate for a pen to go through the W and then continue to the R and then go and fill in the wider strokes. This wouldn't necessarily work from the R to the I, because if you were writing with a pen, you'd come up with the R and then come down the I, and you'd have those two strokes right next to each other. And then you would want a third stroke to thicken the I, and it would either look like the I was pointed at the top, or it would have some weird stuff going on. So with those two, some of the letters, it doesn't work to combine them together, but other letters like this W and R, it's the perfect candidate for them to be a single stroke. So I'm going to join these letters together as one stroke. So at this point, I've been working about 40 minutes on getting this font turned into a writing style font, and I'm finally on my last letter, since this last word, font, I already have an O, an N, and a T created, so the F is my very last letter. So you can see that it does take some time. You know, I've been stopping to kind of talk about what I'm doing, so it's taking me a little longer than it normally would. And as you go through, get more familiar with Inkscape, get more familiar with what you're doing, and practice tracing fonts a lot more often, you will get faster at it. So it's not necessarily something you do for every project or a single one-off project, but if you're doing something like writing invitations, you want something, one thing to look really nice, it can be a really great way to have any font you want be written as a writing style font. Okay, so now I am all done. I'm going to go grab the original font that I was using. I know I've grabbed it because the bounding box is around the whole thing instead of each individual letter. I'm just going to delete that. So this is what our writing font looks like, and you will see it does look very similar to the writing fonts in Cricut Design Space, where you have individual paths. You can see where things are going to be thicker and be thinner. I'm going to go and change my view back from outline to normal. So again, that's view menu, go to display mode menu, and hit normal. And to show you what this might look like with a pen, I'm going to select all of these. And I'm going to look at my stroke menu, and I'm going to increase my stroke width. And this would be the same as using like a wider marker. So you can see how once the strokes are thicker, we wind up with not any gaps between those double lines that we did. You know, there might be one right there, so there might be somewhere where I go in and make those lines a little bit closer together. But it is going to depend on what kind of pen you're using, so it will require a little bit of testing to go and see. Before I save, I'm just going to take the stroke back down to a weight of 1. Sometimes it can look funny when you pull it into Cricut Design Space if the stroke is anything other than 1, so just for peace of mind. And the last thing I'm going to do is one last pass combine. And the reason we're going to do that is because if you don't put all of those on one single path, Cricut Design Space will read each individual stroke we have done and each individual letter as a single layer in Cricut Design Space. So when we are bringing this in and changing it from cut to write, you can either do one go of it or you can do a million for each little letter you did. It won't work if you just do control group, and you can't weld it in Cricut Design Space because it's not a closed stroke, so Cricut Design Space won't let you weld it. So that's why we're going to use the combine tool to do it in here. And finally, we're just going to save this so that we can bring it into Cricut Design Space. I've saved it as an SVG, which is what you want to do. If you save it as a JPEG, it won't work. So now it's time to bring it over into Cricut Design Space. Okay, so now we're in Design Space, and we're just going to quick go to upload image, and we're going to find that image that we just did, save it, and insert it onto our canvas. It's coming in at a little over 9 inches wide. I think I'm just going to use a regular piece of paper to write this, so I'm going to make it a bit smaller so that it will fit on a piece of paper. And we have to go over here and change cut to write. And I'm going to, I think, do this twice so I can try it with a thick and a thin pen. I'm just going to change this to a different pen color. My pens will probably be black. It's just two pens. That's just going to make the machine stop in the middle to let me change out the pen. And you should be good now. So I'm just going to click go, making sure they're appearing one right after each other. And going to click go again. As you can see with the V5 pen, it was a bit too skinny. We would have to probably make the text smaller or add a third stroke, but it does still look kind of nice and pretty, like some of the Cricut writing style fonts have that outline inherent. With the marker, it did much better. Some areas, it's seamless, and a few areas, there is a gap that would have to be fixed by just moving the strokes slightly closer together, but overall, it's a really good start. I hope you've enjoyed this video about how to make any font into a writing style font for Cricut Design Space. It's definitely an advanced technique, but I think if you challenge yourself, you could have some great results.